Good morning, all of you. Yes. So today let us discuss some tricky things about blood pressure in clinical medicine. So we know how to take a blood pressure. Can you demonstrate?
Yes.
Amol, demonstrate how to take the blood pressure in the upper limb.
Yes. Namaste, Kaka. माझं नाव डॉक्टर अमोल आहे. मी तुमच्या हाताचा बी पी घेतोय. ठीक आहे, घेऊ ना.
हो ठीक
आहे. नाउ आय एम टाइंग द कफ. धन्यवाद. बीपी नॉर्मल 120/80 राइट.
सो इन द राइट आर्म इन द सुपाइन पोजिशन. आयडियली वी शुड हैव टेकन द ब्लड प्रेशर. आयडियली व्हेन इन ओपीडी सेटिंग और आयडियली व्हेन वी टेक द ब्लड प्रेशर, द पेशेंट इज सीटेड एक्चुअली एंड द आर्म रेस्ट एट द हार्ट लेवल एंड वी टेक द ब्लड प्रेशर. ओके, इन दिस सिनेरियो वी आर टेकिंग द क्लिनिकल एग्जामिनेशन इन द सुपाइन. सो वी आर कमेंडिंग दैट द सुपाइन ब्लड प्रेशर इज इट नॉर्मल हियर.
Yes.
What was the blood pressure again?
120/80 mmHg.
Okay. So you think it is normal?
Yes, sir.
What is the normal range of blood pressure?
Sir, at systolic 100 to 140 and diastolic it's 90 to 60.
60 to 90 mmHg diastolic. And systolic is 100 to 140 mmHg. Okay. Say, is the thing is over when I take when I ask you to take a blood pressure? And you took blood pressure in 1 hour.
Yes.
Are all the things over now? Or are there any certain situations where you take a different blood pressure in other arm or something like that?
Yes, sir.
What are the scenarios where you take the blood pressure in the opposite arm also? You want to take the blood pressure in that arm also? Why at all you will take? What will trigger you to take the blood pressure in the opposite arm?
The blood high blood pressure, then we will take.
Okay. Okay, you want to say that if there is a high blood pressure in one arm, that provokes you to take the blood pressure in the opposite arm. Is it always, is there any difference between both arm blood pressure, inter-arm difference?
It's a physiological, it is a 10 mmHg.
Okay, physiological inter-arm difference of blood pressure of around 10 mmHg of mercury. So, when you talk of physiology, there is also pathology. So, is there any pathological situation where the inter-arm difference is more than 10 mmHg? There are certain conditions. Can you enlist certain conditions where the inter-arm blood pressure is difference is more than 10 mmHg?
Yes. There are some conditions like arteritis, this Takayasu arteritis. Then sir, any thromboembolic phenomena. Then sir, supravolvular aortic stenosis. Then sir, coarctation. In sometimes a coarctation of aorta.
Okay. Any other situation? One of the most medical emergencies there, chest pain is there, and there is inter-arm difference in the blood pressure, especially in aortic dissection.
Aortic dissection.
So there are certain, there like these situations, like he told, subclavian artery stenosis, thromboembolic disease of one arm, arthritis of one arm, like Takayasu arthritis involving major arteries, and we commented on supravolvular aortic stenosis. And last but not the least, never forget coarctation, never forget aortic dissection, dissection of aorta. And though coarctation of aorta is not that important, but there are certain situations in the coarctations, anatomical location of coarctation is varied, you can have inter-arm difference of blood pressure. Okay, good, correct. So, this is what we, why we should take a blood pressure in the upper limb, in the both upper limbs. This, the trigger factor is high blood pressure. So again, a high blood pressure, that does it triggers us to take blood pressure in any other area?
Yes, sir. If the patient is having hypertension and if there is a wide pulse pressure, especially very low diastolic pressure, then we should go for taking blood pressure in the lower limb.
Okay, very good. You want to say that if there is a blood pressure is high and especially but the diastolic blood pressure is low, in those situations you have to take the blood pressure in the lower limb. What can be the condition where the systolic blood pressure is very high and the diastolic blood pressure is very low? Any pathological cardiovascular condition?
Yes, sir. It can be due to aortic regurgitation.
Yes, aortic regurgitation. And this should trigger us to take the blood pressure in the lower limb. Okay, let us see. First, demonstrate how to take the blood pressure in the lower limb.
नमस्कार काका, मैं आपका ब्लड प्रेशर दूंगा ये फॉर्म में, तो थोड़ा पलट जाएंगे उल्टा।
ठीक है सर।
वी शुड आस्क द पेशेंट टू टर्न टू टेक प्रोन पोजिशन एंड देन वी शुड एक्सपोज द थाई एरिया सो दैट वी कैन द पॉपुलेटिव एरिया इज एक्सपोज। देन वी शुड अप्लाई द कप एंड द ट्यूबिंग शुड बी इन द पैरेलल टू दिस पॉपुलेटिव फोसा एंड देन वी शुड टाई द कप।
So he is tying the blood pressure cuff exactly above the popliteal fossa, and you are taking the blood pressure in which artery?
Sir, we will demonstrate the blood pressure in the popliteal artery.
Okay, you will be recording the popliteal artery pressure.
Yes, sir.
And as you see, the popliteal artery is in the popliteal fossa, and the tubing is exactly in the popliteal fossa. Yes, demonstrate how.
Now we will inflate the cuff. It is 128/84
mm of mercury. Okay, the popliteal artery pressure was 128/84, and what he told about the brachial artery pressure was 120/80. Okay, so it is increased. So your popliteal artery pressure is more than the brachial artery pressure. Is it normal or abnormal?
Sir, it is normal. It should be less than 20. The popliteal artery and the brachial artery pressure should be less than 20 millimeters of mercury.
Okay, you want to say again it is a physiological variation where the lower limb blood pressure is usually more than the upper limb blood pressure and it should not be more than 20 millimeters of mercury. Okay, very good. So this is the way you take the blood pressure in the lower limb. But say for example, we are lucky that our patient is a limb thin person and you could use the arm cuff in the thighs. Say for example, I will give you a scenario where there is a very obese man, obese person, or a very person with a very heavy muscular thighs, and if you apply this cuff, arm cuff there, and it becomes very short for the thigh, and there can be a physiological or a physiologically recording of a wrong blood pressure which is high because of a low circumference of the arm cuff. In those scenarios, are we there? Can we do some modification in taking a lower limb blood pressure, or there is no chance where we can take a lower limb blood pressure? Okay. Anybody?
Yes, sir.
Okay. There is another method of taking the lower limb blood pressure. How?
In such case, we can ask the patient to. We have to take BP in the lower in the leg, just above the ankle joint.
Okay. Very good. Demonstrate it.
Now, see the leg. After measuring. So in this case we have to if the patient is obese and a heptic.
Yeah, I have already given you a scenario to demonstrate.
We have to take BP in the leg by placing a cuff over the leg just above the ankle joint and by inflating.
Okay, yes. So you have to tie the cuff here just above the ankle. And you will be recording blood pressure in which artery then?
Posterior tibial artery. But by placing a stethoscope over the posterior tibial artery, then
okay. Posterior tibial artery. You record the blood pressure. So okay, now you recorded the blood pressure in the posterior tibial artery, that is the BP 120/84, as the same what you told the lower limb blood pressure. Okay, so can you talk about a scenario, why at all he gave an idea that in aortic regurgitation, what is the classical significance of taking a lower limb blood pressure in aortic regurgitation?
Sir, there is a clinical contribution of a disease in case of AR by taking BP in the lower limb.
Okay.
Hill sign.
What is hill sign?
Sir, normally there is a blood pressure difference in the lower limb and the upper limb is less than 20 mmHg in systolic blood pressure. If the blood pressure is more than 20/40 mmHg in systolic blood pressure, that is mild. If there is moderate AR, there is a 40-60 mmHg. If the more than 60 mmHg, that is severe AR.
Okay.
So severity of the AR is quantified.
Okay, yes. Severity of AR is quantified by the taking the lower limb blood pressure. If it is 20-40 mm of mercury more then the brachial, then it is mild 40 to 60, moderate more than 60 is severe. So this is the way you quantify the aortic regurgitation severity clinically by taking the blood pressure only. So heel sign is the only sign which quantifies. Okay. Is there any situation where reverse occurs? Like say for example, you take the blood pressure in the upper limb and it is high, and as a matter of fact, as a normal trigger, now you took the blood pressure in the lower limb, and the lower limb blood pressure came unexpectedly low than the upper limb blood pressure. Which is pathological always, because we told that physiologically it is increased, now it is decreased. Any situation?
So there is a condition, there is a compression of aorta. In that condition, there is a BP in the upper limb is more than the BP in the lower limb.
Oh, compression of aorta. Very good, very good.